Hi, my name is Silvia Caneva from WIPER Renewable Energies. I'm very happy to provide my contribution for the peer-to-peer trading and energy community. But before going in details to this relevant topic, please let me provide you an overview on the status where we are. We are, at the time being, in the status of a climate emergency. As you see from this graph, in 2023, in February, we have reached an increase of 1.2 degrees Celsius. And if we proceed with this trend in 2035, in April 2035, we will reach 1.5 degrees. That is this maximum limit given by the Paris Agreement. So we know the consequences of climate change. We know that it undermines our health, the water supply, our condition on these planets. And we know that if we keep warming with the CO2 emission, we will really come to a situation to put under dangers the life on this planet. Not only the nature, because the nature then will be able for sure to find, let's say, a solution, but the life for the human beings is really under danger. So there are solutions for these climate emergencies. What we have to do is to decarbonize as soon as possible our energy system, and we can do this with a social tipping intervention. Where we define a social tipping intervention and a kind of contagion spread of behavior or information. We have seen this, for instance, in the social media. We have seen this, the spread of the virus with the pandemic, the COVID-19. And then what we have to do is to have this kind of social tipping intervention in the society, in order to reach a point that is named leverage tipping points, where the behavior of several citizens, several group of citizens in the society, are able to create a change in the climate, so a change in the system. Peer-to-peer energy trading system is one of the solutions that we can use for the decarbonization. In the peer-to-peer energy trading system, we have a prosumer and a consumer. The prosumer usually is a prosumer generating renewable energy electricity with a photovoltaic system. He has usually a photovoltaic system on the roof. And then we have a consumer that is able to receive this energy. The consumer and the prosumer are connected through the grid, the electricity grid, and also to internet. These are the basic of the peer-to-peer trading platform. And then in order to have this platform working, we need a smart contract. In the smart contract, you have usually the transition of the energy and then the monetization of the energy in money. And that's why the prosumer and the consumer, they both need a wallet to see the conversion of their electricity in money. Usually now we use cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin, Ethereum. This smart contract in this example, in the slide, is based on Ethereum, for instance. So with these characteristics, prosumer, consumer, smart contract in a wallet, and then of course the electricity grid and the internet, you can have really a peer-to-peer platform that usually they are managed by blockchain at the time being. We have several peer-to-peer platforms in the world. The first one was built in New York, in Brooklyn. As you can see, we have here several photovoltaic systems installed on the roof of the buildings. In this system, with this system, the citizens, they can exchange electricity, renewable energy electricity in their neighborhood. And this is the first, as I said, peer-to-peer platform. In the framework of the SocialRes project, we have also created a peer-to-peer platform that is, as consequence, generating an energy community, because the peer-to-peer platform are able to connect several persons, several citizens, and that's why we call them energy community. Tracklabel, that is an utility base in Bucharest, in Romania, has created a peer-to-peer platform in the Arbor Garden. Here we have several villas with a photovoltaic system. And also in this case, in the peer-to-peer platform, we have different ingredients, let's say different components. So we have the consumer, the prosumer, the renewable energy producer, and the platform provider. So the platform provider in this case is Tracklabel. A Tracklabel with this peer-to-peer platform has the possibility to be a service provider, so not any longer a producer of energy, maybe based on fossil fuels, but they can now provide a platform that is creating then a possibility for the citizens to communicate in peer-to-peer platform. This is a simulation that Tracklabel has done for more than 1,000 users. We have, as you can see, different prosumer consumers. What is very important to see in this slide is that Tracklabel, so the service provider, is able to get revenue. In 1 year, more or less 40,000 euros he was able to get from the fee of the platform. So here is important to understand that utility that now today they are producing energy with fossil fuels, they are able to become service provider. And so they could be the company, the organization providing the platform to habilitate consumer and prosumer to exchange renewable energy electricity. So this is really an important step in the mitigation of the global warming, so in this climate emergency, because utility can really have a new business model for the future. When they will not be able to produce any longer energy with fossil fuel, they can really become service provider, platform or provider, or peer-to-peer platform. You have more information for this peer-to-peer platform in the Social Res report that is in the Social Res website, and also on the ESIP. ESIP is the European Energy Social Innovation Platform that was created from the Social Res project. In this platform, you have a report that I have written about energy democracy, where we go really in detail about this peer-to-peer platform. If you should have any question, please do not hesitate to contact me. So my email address is silvia.caneva@wip-munich.de. You can find anyhow also several information on the ESIP platform, so www.eesip.eu. Do not hesitate to contact me, because we can now really provide our contribution for the global warming mitigation.